Hello, welcome to the test shop here at Saws UK. This is our semi-automatic machine. It's a 510 SAF. It's a machine designed for the fabrication industry. Its best feature is the pivot point here. When you cut flats and bottom parts of box sections, you often have too many teeth in engagement. You've seen this happen, blades jamming in the job, etc. It's very aggravating. It's expensive on blades, it's time consuming. Well, this machine, having the lower pivot point, means that when it's cutting through the flats or the bottom parts of box sections, it's actually scissoring through it. So you haven't got too many teeth in engagement with the material. The blade tensioning is applied here. There is a gauge so you can get it right every time. The blade is guided through ball bearings here and then again through carbides here. The same is repeated, of course, at the other end of the machine. The blade, incidentally, is 34 millimeters. There's adequate coolant here. You can have our optional mist system, which puts minute possets of vegetable oil on the blade. This means you won't have oil on the floor. This machine has, as an optional extra, a laser fitted so you can see a line. So if you're marking the workpiece and then cutting, you'll see your marked workpiece. Down this end, of course, is a very heavy-duty gearbox. It's filled for life with a synthetic oil and a very large motor to power it all. At this end of the machine, there is a removable swarf tray, so you can slide this out and empty all your swarf out at the end of the day. Underneath, there is a coolant tank, which also is removable. We obviously recommend changing your coolant every 3 months. Right, the control panel here, you can see this is the height setting. So basically, if you want the machine to come just above your workpiece, supposing your workpiece is 250 millimeters, you then set this to 250 millimeters by just keying it in here. At the moment, the machine is at 240 millimeters because that's where it came to a rest last time. Over here is a piece counter, a simple piece counter. That means that if somebody distracts you while you're cutting a material off, at least you know how many you've done. Over here is the mitering of the machine, and you can just unclamp the machine, move it round and miter with it, and clamp it accordingly. I'll show you that later on when we do some cuts. The clamping of the machine is automatic, so when you press start in semi-automatic mode, it will clamp. It will go down and do the cut, and then it will come back up again and unclamp. But if you wish, you can have it so that it comes back up again and stays clamped. You might want to remove the material later. Over here are the simple controls. Basically a start and a stop, obviously an emergency stop button, the safety switch, which you have to press when you start the machine up initially, and the down feed rate of the bow, the speed that the bow comes down through the work, nicely numbered here. So in a minute, I'll put a piece of flat material in here and you'll see how well it cuts. I'll also demonstrate how it miters. So mitering is very simple on this machine. It's 60 degrees each way. You just unclamp with this lever here. You can pull the machine round to any angle, which will be displayed on the screen, and then simply clamp it here. If you're going the opposite way, swivel it round here, again looking at the screen to see where your miter angle is, locking it here, and all you have to do is unpinch this vise, move it across out of the way. When you've finished mitering and you want to just do straight cuts, you have an absolute stop here for zero. Just lower it down, bring it against the stop there, and clamp it off in the usual way, and you're at zero. There is a video regarding recalibrating this, which you can do yourselves. It's a training video. So this is the control panel that you saw earlier. The only thing I didn't show you was the blade speed. We're about to cut a piece of mild steel plate. I'd run that around 70 meters per minute. The machine will go down, do the cut, go back up again. I've set it round for 15 degrees. You'll see it scissoring through the cut. Obviously, the wider the plate is, the more defined that will be, but you'll actually see it scissoring through that piece of plate.